welcome to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, Terra's Route. And it looks like we're going to go and attempt to save someone who probably doesn't actually need saving. And I'm guessing we have to go back to like the main courtyard area. I really hate these ones that blow up every time. And then become invincible. It's really annoying. So far off track for multiple reasons. I'm not entirely sure what to say right now. I do think that Terra is a tad easily manipulated for the one that's supposed to be. So, like, you have Aqua, who's this kind of idealist and always plays by, you know, the proper rules. But at the same time, she has her own level of naivete in that she believes in the answer. She appears to believe in the answers that are black and white. And then you have Ventus, who's basically the absolute pinnacle of just innocence in that he doesn't really fully understand anything that is going on. He doesn't even have... I would argue that, like, his even sense of right and wrong are a little blurred. But not like you would expect a balanced character to see them blurred. It's more like he just doesn't see them at all, rather than understanding the different sides of the same coin. And then you have Terra. Terra is supposed to kind of see the... At least my initial reaction to the character is that Terra is supposed to be the one who kind of sees between the lines a little bit. And he may not realize that he's going towards the darkness, but he has justifications for everything that he does. But that doesn't seem to be the case. It seems like he's just easily pulled in one direction or another. And so, I don't know. I don't know what to make of Terra yet. Maybe it's just... One of the problems with Kingdom Hearts, as much as I love this game series, is that they kind of rely on a handful of personalities and then just swap them at random within the universe. Terra isn't that much different from Riku. Ventus isn't that much different from Sora. Aqua isn't that much different from Kairi. Like, they are all kind of, they work within the same realms of personality. So, maybe I'm reading too much into a character whose arc we've kind of seen a couple of times over already within the series. But, I don't know. I think Riku was a bit more compelling. Alright, I'm not dealing with that thing. Is this the right way? I don't know. I wasn't actually paying that much attention during the cutscene, so... You know, worst case scenario, we'll just wander around here doing some, levels, and then eventually stumble onto the next, story point. I'm not even gonna say plot point, because I feel like the plot of Kingdom Hearts as a whole has become very muddled. Like, the first game in the series, actual Kingdom Hearts, had a very clear end goal. And Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories had this kind of mystery going on, but you still had a pretty clear idea. With splitting these three characters up, and you play through the same story every time, like, you already kind of know what's coming. You're just seeing it from a different perspective. But then new questions are added, and to the point where you kind of lose what exactly it is is your kind of supposed to do? Yes. Oh, what are the Unversed? Well, we know what the Unversed are. We learned that in both Aqua and Ventus's storylines. Especially Ventus. We already learned where the Unversed come from. We already know. So this isn't really much of a mystery for us at this point. And so you kind of end up looking at things less at the overall, especially when it's split up between characters like this, it's less about the overall plot and more about character development. But here's the thing, I don't really, like, we're already at Radiant Guardian, Radiant Guardian, bleh. And I don't know, maybe it's too soon to expect any level of growth from Terra. I mean, I guess it is a little early to expect any growth from Terra. It's just like, you can already see it's going to paint him out as a victim, and like he was tricked by Xehanort and he ended up succumbing to the darkness within himself, but like that could also be said of Riku and Maleficent from the first game. But where Riku was an ignorant child, Terra is very much I don't know if you'd call him a hardened warrior, but he has some experience in this world. He has some experience with the knowledge of Kingdom Hearts, with the knowledge of why you wield a Keyblade that Riku didn't have. So to a certain extent, I would expect more of him and for him to not be so easily manipulated. I guess he was still kind of sheltered, but I don't know, maybe I'm expecting too much from Terra. It's just, I don't know, I have problems with all of them. I think Aqua needs to get off the high horse, I think Ventus needs to smarten up a little bit, and Terra, I think, needs to learn to be suspicious and not necessarily blindly trust authority. But it's something that I don't know if it's going to actually be resolved. So that's Castletown. So where am I going? I don't know what to make of this whole thing. At least I am gaining at some levels. Better make sure. Okay, where the fuck do I go? Like, as far as I can tell, I could not get through this gate. Because it's blocked. So then I guess maybe I didn't travel far enough over here. Well, we're gonna beeline it for the very outer edge. Oh, wait. Okay. I did not notice that on the map before. So if we go in here, there we go. That's where we were supposed to go.
Master Xehanort!
The old coot certainly knows how to take punishment. Just like I know how to deal it out.
You monster! What are you after?
That thing right there. It's called the Keyblade, isn't it? Yep. Seems like these days everybody's got one of those. Even Grandpa there. When I nabbed him, he told me all about it. What a weapon like that can do. How could I not want one?
But you'll find they're picky about their owners.
If I heard the old guy right, you're what they call Keyblade Master Material. So if I defeat you, that makes me the real Keyslinger, if you catch my drift. Not the most polite way to go about it, but what can you do?
Hit it!
One more step and the coot goes boom. You think I'm gonna fight fair? As if. That key's too powerful for us to go mano a mano. For a Keyblade Master, you're not very... what's the word? Good?
What are you doing, Terra? Fight!
But Master, you'll...
Never mind me! You must fight! You can't let this ruffian win! Think of your master, Ericus! The shame he and your fellow pupils would be forced to bear! Use the Keyblade!
So much for the bluff!
Sorry about that. My family member doesn't really understand the concept of waiting. So, we'll get back to it. Alright, so now we have to fight Yafar, which is really annoying. No, you don't. Back down, good. So, the beauty about Terra is that this is very much a brute force type of fight. Okay, maybe not. Well, here we go. Yeah, and I mean, by showing us his perspective, it's pretty easy to see where he's aiming, and it's not hard to dodge.
Come on.
There we go. can reflect his gun back at him. I'm so close. Come on, fucker. Damn it.
I can see you.
Come on. So close. Oh, fuck you. There we go. So that's how he got his
scar. This power.
Well done, Terra. You have taken yet another step forward.
But I was consumed by anger. Hatred. That was the power of darkness.
Darkness that you channeled.
No. I succumbed to it. Just like when I stole Princess Aurora's Heart of Light. I can never return home now. I'm a failure.
Then don't. You could be my pupil. Master Ericus, you see, is so afraid of darkness that he too has succumbed. Not to darkness, but to light. It shines so bright, he forgets that light begets darkness. And Aqua and Ventus, their lights shine too bright. It is only natural that they cast shadows on your heart. Ericus. You're such a fool. Light and darkness, they are a balance. One that must always be maintained. Terra. You are the one who shows the true mark of mastery, but he refuses to see it. And I know why. It is because he fears you. Join me. You and I can do the world's much greater good by wielding light and darkness in equal shares.
Master Xehanort.
See more worlds. Seek out the darkness that upsets the balance. Find Vanitas and bring an end to him. Master. Terra.
Do that, Ven.
Why not?
When I really need you, Ven, I know you'll be there.
Well, why wouldn't I? You're my friend.
Yeah. You're right. Thanks, Ven.
You old coot! You said I wouldn't get hurt! I didn't sign up to be collateral damage! No way! As if! Okay, okay, fine, fine! Just put that down. You still need me. You still need me to do something, right? And all I'm asking is that you hold up your end of the bargain. I mean, what's a little scratch on my face, huh? All things considered. I'm just lucky you didn't steal my heart like Princess whatever it was. That would have ruined my week for sure.
Unlikely. A powerful light still lives inside of Terra. You see, people like him, they don't have the power to steal hearts.
So wait, you mean he's not the one who stole her heart?
So we finished up there. Before we move on, I'm going to go ahead and end the part here and deal with the family situation. And I will be back. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.